Good morning, good morning, good morning. Buenos dias, mi gente, yo-yo. Welcome to Daily Discipline number 736, primarily in a row. My name's Rob Hoback. Happy that you're here. Honored and humbled that you keep coming back, like, for reals. Hey, it's Thursday. On Thursdays, we have Thank Yous Thursdays. We talk about how important it is to be thankful for what you got, right? The date is October 22nd, 2020. It's a work day. I've got work to do. Let's do it. First things first, still the realist. I am also whip, work in progress. So is our football team. We had another loss last night. It was a winnable game, and it's just a struggle. It's a tough year, and I feel bad for the kids, but we're not going to give up. We've got two regular season games, then there's a postseason tournament, and I think we can play better. We just have to get ourselves organized. So the real talk for today is that we're going to finish on empty. We're going to finish on empty. Aeneas Williams, Hall of Fame football player, in his Hall of Fame speech, said two things. I'll leave you with two thoughts. Number one, finish on empty. Don't leave any. Don't stop. Like Wayne Dyer says, don't stop with the music still in your head. Like, we're not done yet, right? We're gonna finish on empty. The other thing they says is begin with the end in mind, right? And the end in mind here is that I want these kids to enjoy this football season, to look back and say, I want to do this again. And then play next year. And as of right now, that's not where we are. We're headed in the right direction. We're not there. We're going to finish on empty. Let's do our thank yous and we're done for the day. God's been good to us in the good times and the bad. Even come through a rough season right now, he's been with us, right? Thank you for Sam. Sam had a big play last night. That's a whole nother story. But he is, I'm proud of him. I'm just proud of him. I'm proud of Addison. She's out there doing her work right now. She got up. We got home late from football last night. I was letting them sleep in. I mean, it was like 11 o'clock. Kids fell asleep in the car and stuff. And anyway, she just got up and went right to work. She's amazing. Thankful for Aunt Jen, who comes to almost all of our games. It's such a pleasure. It's such a blessing to have her here to where we get to see her all the time. And I feel bad because I'm always like giving her a hug, like at the end of a game, and I'm upset. And anyway, I'm thankful for Aeneas Williams and that great advice. I was sitting here thinking, I'm like, man, we're so close. We have to make some tough calls. We have to make some tough decisions, but we're not done yet, right? And I still have plenty in the tank. Thankful for the QE1, who always takes good care of us, and just thankful. Thankful to have somebody like her in our network. I'm thankful for B Swish, one of the coaches. He and his son tested positive, and we really missed them last night. Thankful for SMAC, another one of the other coaches who is he is always positive, good team player. We've got a good nucleus there. And I'm also thankful for today, tomorrow. I'm thankful for it all, right? Especially when you're walking through the nonsense, walking through the shit, you just got to remember that the green light's on the other side. We just have to keep going. Finish on empty. Don't leave anything in the tank, right? With that, we're done. Hands up. Peace out. We're better together. Appreciate you stopping by on a Thank Yous Thursday. This is your reminder, right? If you want to be happy, start there. Be thankful for what you got, not the things you think you want. You know, like, we thought we should have had a win last night, but we didn't, right? So we could be upset about that, or we could be thankful for what we got, right? Especially during the adversity. With that, yeah, we got to go. We'll see you tomorrow. Love you guys. Bye.